Hi, in this video, I will show you how to connect a Bluetooth switch, much like this one, to your Sesame device. With it, you will be able to turn on your phone and start the Sesame service without the use of our voice commands or the use of your hands. In this case, I will show you how to configure a two-button switch, but the instructions would work for a single switch as well. So to start off, let's turn on the screen and open the device. First thing I want to do is to connect the switch through the Bluetooth to my phone. I'll go to the Bluetooth controls, turn the Bluetooth on, and if I have a pairing switch on my switch, I will press that so my phone can find it. Now I know my device, my switch is called Bluetooth. I'll choose that. And now I'm connected to my Bluetooth switch. Let's go back. The next stage is to allow the smart lock. Now, this is not mandatory. This will allow the switch to open the device when it's locked, even if you have a code. This is your call if you want to use this option. Next thing I'm going to do, go back to the settings right up here. Can get to it from the main menu as well, and scroll all the way down to the accessibility features of Android. And what interests me here is the switch access. Choose switch access and turn it on. It will ask me for permission. I will allow it. Now I'm going to configure the way my Bluetooth switch interacts with my phone through the switch access. I prefer the row column scanning method, so I'm going to leave the default values there. You can change it later if you prefer. I will leave the default scanning highlight style. You can change that, different colors, speed, etc. I want the auto scan feature, so I will turn that on and I will leave the default value of 1 second. You can change that as well. Now I'm moving on to assign the keys for scanning. Now, the two features I want to define are auto scan, when the scanning starts, and how to select what I choose. Since I have two buttons, I will assign the first button to start the auto scan. Click OK. And the second button for the select and click OK. If I were to have only one button, I would assign only the auto scan button, and then the first time I press would be starting the auto scan and the second to select. Now I can go back to the main screen. Now I want to make sure that my soft keyboard will continue to appear on the screen. So I go to the language and input settings and click on the current keyboard option. As you can see, it chooses my switch as the keyboard input. So I want to turn this off. And now you can see this option is off. Going back to the main screen, and now I'll show you how I turn on the device and start Sesame. We have two options for doing that. I'll show you the short one first, and then I'll show the long one. To begin, I press on the button that starts the auto scan. Press it again, and you will see a green rectangle moving on around the features on the screen, and I will use the second button to choose it. Now I'm scanning the elements on the screen. And the second green rectangle on Open Sesame, I choose Select. And now Sesame is started, and I can control my phone just as I would turning it on with the Open Sesame voice command. Now for the second option, turning on the device. I will close the phone. Click on the auto scan button. I'll click it again and choose the unlock option. Now the phone is unlocked. Now I would like to start the Sesame service. I press the auto scan button again. And again, I see the green rectangle moving around the screen, and I will wait until it chooses the notification area. That's where I'm going to select. Now back, home, notifications. In the notifications area, I start the auto scan again, and I will wait for the second green rectangle on the Open Sesame notification. Click select, and again, I get control over the phone using head tracking. And that's all there is to it. Thank you very much.